Now after the formula for that d theta by dt is equal to du by dv. Now let us move towards the first fundamental law of your fluid mechanics, that is Newton's law of viscosity. First fundamental law of fluid mechanics is Newton's law of viscosity. Newton's law of viscosity says that the shear stress which you apply on a fluid particle to make the fluid to flow, that shear stress is directly proportional to the rate of shear strain, d theta by dt. Right? Shear stress is directly proportional to the rate of shear strain. Right? If you remember your strength of material, we say that the shear stress is directly proportional to the shear strain, because there the shear strain is not a function of time. But here we have to take the function of time as a, we have to consider that the shear strain is a function of time. So the Newton says that the shear stress acting on a fluid particle or on a fluid element is directly proportional to the d theta by dt. And if you remember from our earlier your derivation, that d theta by dt is equal to du by dy. We already derived this, that d theta by dt is equal to du by dy. So from here I can write shear stress is directly proportional to the velocity gradient in the direction which is perpendicular to the direction of flow. That tau is directly proportional to the du by dy. And if I remove this proportionality sign, I got a constant. That constant is your mu into du by dy. If I remove the proportionality sign, we got a constant, and that constant is your mu, and mu is known as absolute or dynamic viscosity. Mu is a property which is known as absolute or dynamic viscosity. So this is the Newton's law of viscosity, that tau is equal to mu into du by dy. Right? If you remember, we discussed that if there is no shear stress, then there should not be any effect of viscosity. So if you say from here, if shear stress is zero on a fluid element, then mu is also zero. Right? We cannot see the effect of viscosity if the fluid is not moving. And also we say that if du by dy you put it as a zero, right? If du by dy is not there, if there is no relative velocity, right? So from here you can say that if this du by dy is zero, there is no relative velocity in that, then there is no shear stress. Then there is no shear stress, right? So we will discuss what is the meaning of this. If du by dy is zero, then the shear stress is zero. We'll discuss it. So mu is the absolute or dynamic viscosity. So if you see from here, you can write mu is equal to tau upon du by dy. And if you find out the unit of this, the unit of stress is Newton per meter square, SI units. Velocity unit is meter per second divided by y unit is meter. So the unit of this viscosity will be Newton second per meter square. This is the SI unit. Sorry. So the SI unit of mu, SI unit of dynamic or absolute viscosity is Newton second per meter square. And you know that what is Newton per meter square? Newton second per meter square. And we know that what is this Newton per meter square? Newton per meter square is Pascal. It is Pascal. So you can write it as a Pascal second also. Right? It is written as Pascal second also. right? And also you can, there are so many units you can convert it into. So let us convert it into one another form. It is Newton second per meter square. One Newton is equal to, you know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Force unit is Newton, mass is kg, acceleration is meter per second square. So in place of Newton, I can write kg meter per second square. Here is 1 second divided by meter square. So it will be, second and square will cancel, this will cancel. It will be kg per meter second. Kg per meter second. So the unit of mu, the SI unit of mu is, either you can write Newton second per meter square, or Pascal second also you can write, or kg per meter second also you can write. These are the SI units of absolute viscosity or dynamic viscosity. These are the SI units. If we want to find what is the CGS unit of mu, right? There are various systems. One is SI system, CGS system. So if you want to find CGS, so we have Newton second per meter square. This is the SI unit. If you want to convert it into CGS, in CGS, Newton is dyne, second is second divided by centimeter square, right? In CGS, meter can be replaced with centimeter square and Newton is dyne. So this is known as one poise. This is known as one poise. This value is known as one poise, right? So if you convert it into, you will get that one poise is equal to 0.1 kg per meter second. So you can convert SI unit and CGS unit with the help of this formula, that one poise is equal to 0.1 of Pascal second or 0.1 of Newton second per meter square. You can convert it into like this, right? So this is all about your Newton's law of viscosity, that is shear stress is equal to mu into du by dy, and mu is the dynamic or absolute viscosity. One another term we have that is known as kinematic viscosity can be represented by the letter nu. Kinematic viscosity is represented by the letter nu, and kinematic viscosity is equal to the ratio of absolute viscosity divided by density of the fluid. This will be mu upon rho is equal to nu. Right? Kinematic viscosity is mu upon rho. If we talk about the units, what is the SI unit if we want to talk? What is the SI unit of kinematic viscosity? What is the unit of mu? Mu you can written as kg per meter second. This is mu divided by density is kg per meter cube. So this will be meter square per second. So this is the SI unit of mu. This is the SI unit. And if you want to find what is the CGS unit, CGS unit will be, in place of meter, it will be centimeter square upon second. And this centimeter square upon second is known as stock. So you can write from here that 1 meter square per second, you can write it as 10,000 centimeter square per second. So you can write 1 meter square per second is equal to 10 raised to power 4 stock. So this is the CGS unit of your kinematic viscosity mu, right?